Hello everyone, welcome to BISPSolutions.com. My name is Sumit and I am VP Sales of CRM Solutions with BISP. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how can we perform data transformation in Wave. So we have already gone through the data transformation by using customizing JSON. Now this is a new update which has been recently released by Wave 2017 that now we can perform data transformations like data augment, data filtering, data compute expressions, edge mart, SFDC digest, and all type of transformations which are available in Wave can be done without customizing JSON. It's like a piece of cake, like simply dragging and dropping and adding fields into it, and the transformation will be done in a very easy and efficient way. So in this video, I'm going to demonstrate you same that how are we going to perform a couple of transformations like compute expressions, filtering, and so on by using the new update in 2017 in Wave. So let's begin. So for this, I'm using opportunity dataset, which has I have been loaded from Salesforce, directly from Salesforce. And we have got an opportunity data set, and now I would like to apply a filter and compute expression on top of that. So right now you see we don't have any opportunity data set. So the very first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new data set by getting data directly from Salesforce. I'm looking for opportunity data. So I select opportunity object. And let's add the fields like amount, close date, country, expected amount, fiscal year, name of opportunity, opportunity type, probability, stage. So I have added around 9 fields. Now if you look at the JSON, so that's the JSON code for it. So we can save this JSON. So before saving this JSON, because this JSON does not contain any alias and name, so we need to save it. So I create a data set, give name as opportunity, and create it. Create. Yes. And now we need to data flow view. So either we can start it, or you know that we have an option for scheduling as well. So this is I'm doing it first time, or I'm doing it only once. So I simply click on start. So the process will start. We can see the process. Once the process is completed, we would be able to see the successful message. And the new data set has been created. So a new data has been created successfully. So let's go and figure it out. Close it. Browse. Data set, and we have a new data set named as opportunity. So we can do visualization on top of that. We can add measures. I can say sum of amount, and I can further group by stage. So my requirement is I would like to, before loading this data into Wave Analytics, I would like to apply a filter that it will load only closed one opportunities. Or if we say count of rows, so there it should load only closed one opportunities. So basically, I would like to filter the record, filter the opportunity data set, and create a separate data set out of it and share it with a user specific group of people or to other users. So let's have a look how can we do that. So for this, first of all, we need to switch to data manager. So previously we were doing this by using customizing JSON. To know more about data transformation, how to perform data transformation by using JSON, you can go through my previous video. You can get the link in the option below. So I click on data manager, switch to data flow view. Just for safety purpose, I simply download the JSON, the current JSON for it. And that's the current JSON for opportunity. So I'll just save it and show in a folder, and I copy and paste it on my desktop so that if we have to use it, we can use it again. Now click on edit. Now, by default, if you look at here, we have two nodes, 101 and 102. 101, it comprises of all the fields along with the output. These are the output fields. And in 102, it holds the output fields along with the name of the data set. So in between, I would like to add a filter. So first of all, the first requirement is create a separate data set containing records whose state is closed one. So basically, we would like to apply a filter. It is something like we can consider or we can relate data transformation, we can relate filters as a view in SQL datasets, in our data, in relational datasets. So we have a lot of, we have the transformations. These are the various transformations. We have SFDC, digest, edgemart, append, augment, compute expression, compute relative, flatten, filter, a slice digest, update, and SFDC register. So I'm looking for a filter. So I select filter, click on filter expression. First of all, to assign a name to that filter. So I assign a name as filter expression. Click on continue. Now here, the source. So I want to apply a filter on 101. So I select 101. And the filter, I apply the filter, let's say stage name EQ closed one. So that's the syntax for applying filter. Save it. And you can see the filter expression has been added, and now we link this filter expression with SFDC digest. So now this is in between. And what I'm doing, I'm just changing the name of this as filter opportunity and filter opportunity. And we can see output fields, stage name with filter expression. Save it. Let's go and check the JSON file. So that's the JSON 101. Then we have a filter node in between. So that's the source is 101. We applied a filter, stage name EQ closed one, action is filter and parameters. And this, the node is filter expression. So the source is filter expression and the name of new node will be filter opportunity. So that's fine. It's okay. I just close it. And now we are going to update it. So if we want, we can download the JSON and share it with the users, or we can upload a new JSON or existing one. So I click on update data flow. You will give a message. It will give a message that saving this data flow will override your saved data flow. That's why I saved the previous one, so that if we have to roll back to the previous, flow, we would be able to get it. So I click on continue. And we'll get back to data manager, and once again we refresh it. We refresh this, we can verify whether it is updated or not. So I click on download here, and you can see a new node we have added as a filter one. So let's update it now, and I'll start this process. So now you can see the process has been completed successfully. Now let's go and check. So I click on, I just close it, browse all data set, and we will have a new opportunity named as opportunity one. So I just click on this opportunity one, and let's figure it out. So the filtered records we have, right. So you see, now we'll be getting opportunity one, and there are 385 records. And if I want to further filter it by stage, we'll be getting only one stage, that is closed one. That is because we have applied a filter. So that's how we can apply a filter by using data transformation. Now, in continuation of that, if I switch to tables view, in tables view, we'll be getting these all are the records whose stage is closed one, but we have a field called amount. So I would like to calculate, I would like to perform computed expression on this amount field, and I want to have a derived column, derived field named the text calculation based on this column. So for this, let's quickly switch to data manager. Let's see how to achieve it. So I switch to data manager, then click on data flow view, and here click on edit. So we'll have a filter expression and SFDC register. Now I want to have one computed expression on this filter expression. So we'll have one computed expression. So I click on computed expression, and this would be, let's say, text calculation, continue, and the source would be filter expression. I want to apply a filter on means what. Let's say the source is 101, and yes, I want to merge it with source and the computed field. So I click on add fields. It would be number type, it would be numeric type, and the expression would be the field name is amount we have. So if you switch to opportunity one, in opportunity one, I'll switch to value table because I want to get the names. So it is amount. So it is, I just mentioned here amount. I want to calculate 10%. So amount multiplied 10 divided by 100. Precision is 2, scale is 2, default value is 0. And let's say precision is 5. I think 2 is 0. 2 is sufficient. Scale is 8. Scale is 5. Default value 0 and save it. Save it. And we would like to add this text calculation. And it would be merged with 101. So we can have a look. So again, this is a JSON. Then we have filter expression, and there is a text calculation on. So it would be merged with source. It would be merged with source, but it should go along with the data set. So what I would be doing, I would be applying it on filter transformation, and then we will add it. So I'll just customize it. And the source, I just put it on filter transformation, filter expression, save it. And this would be linked with, this will be linked with 10. So this is, so the flow is like this. So I have done some changes here. I removed that filter expression, and then this I changed as computed opportunity. It should be computed opportunity. This also computed opportunity. And output fields we have, these are the output fields along with text. So save it and update data flow. So as you can see here, when I'm trying to update this data flow, I'm getting an error message, and the error message is that the scale must be less than the precision. So we need to figure it out. We need to solve this. So I just edit this. That's the field, and the scale I set as one, and save it and update the flow. So it is updated successfully. Let's go to data manager and start the process. So before that, let's refresh it once again. And then we will start the process so that we can work it, and then it will, so that it will work properly and we'll get the update. So I'll just click on start. The process gets started. We can validate it. So you can see the process has been successfully completed. We got a successful message. Let's go back to analytics, browse all data set. And the data set we have is computed opportunity. So I click on computed opportunity, and I'll display as a value tables. And in value tables, we have a field called text, and this is the 10%. If you look at this text, the amount is six. Let's just refresh. The amount is 8577295, and the 10% is 857730. So that's how we calculated the text. That's how we created a derived column by using the new feature of data flow, the data transformation. There are a couple of other features which we can use as we have done by using JSON. So instead of customizing the code, we can do it. We can transform it simply by dragging and dropping and adding nodes between the source and the destination node. So that's all in this video. If you have any queries, you can write to us on www.bispsolutions.com. We are not only providing trainings on Salesforce, we'll be giving job support as well as consultancy services on Salesforce as well. You can visit our website to know more about the consultant services we are offering to our clients.